Hello, welcome to the hands-on lab chemistry experiment video series. And today in this video series I would like to show you column chromatography. So this is very common technique which we use in organic chemistry, and I would like to show you how you can perform or how you can learn the concept of column chromatography at your home. So first I will show you some brief introduction and then material, and then we'll start the procedure. So let's read little bit literature about this one. So here is a little bit about the description of column chromatography. This is a very common technique used in organic chemistry to separate individual compounds from a mixture. And the basic principle, so you can pause this video to read this literature. Basically there are two types of column chromatography: normal phase and reverse phase. And in case of normal phase, polar stationary phase we use, and in reverse phase, non-polar stationary phase we use. In mobile phase would be non-polar solvent, all organic and no water, and we elute first the least polar compounds in the normal phase column chromatography. So we will pay more attention today on this normal phase column chromatography to show you how it works in the lab. Here is this another sheet that how we fill the column in the lab. So basically you can watch, you can pause this video to review this one. This is empty column. Basically we add first petroleum ether, which is non-polar solvent, and Teflon cork must be closed. Then we add dry silica gel here, around 5 gram, and then to elute, to let it open so that all the petroleum ether can go. And then we add clean sand, and the petroleum ether must be filled in this one. Next is then we add the mixture of compound solution in petroleum ether and DCM, and then we start eluting. So this is the way we use the column chromatography in the lab. And now I will show you what are the ingredients we are going to use, or material we are going to use here in the home. So let's start from here. That so here we have material. First we are taking here plain papers and then cutting like small pieces like this one. I'm taking here is like a simple white printing paper. You can take any paper. Then second is scissor, and third is a pen. And I make it this pen empty. I remove the refill from inside, and so basically I need one empty shell. This will be my column. This will work like my column. So we need pens, and then here we need two rubber bands which will work like a holder. And then here paper towel holder. So this is my paper towel holder. I remove the paper towels here. It's right now only paper towel holder. Then we need a dropper and some small thin drinking straw, or you can see used in coffee mixing. So dropper or drinking straw. Then we need some cotton balls. So cotton balls, I will use this as a stationary phase to fill in the column like a silica gel. Then as a vitamin E capsule, here you can see these are the vitamin E capsule, and these vitamin E capsules are facial oil, and this will behave like a non-polar compound. It have very unique smell, like a fish smell. So if you do not find this vitamin E capsule, you can use omega-3 fish oil. So omega-3 have a long chain fatty acid. This will also behave like a non-polar compound. So you can use either fish oil or omega-3, and both are easily available in everywhere in a drug store or medicine store or in grocery store. Next is the brown sugar, which will behave like a polar compound, which is water soluble. I'm using the brown sugar so that I can see the color when it will flows. Vegetable oil as a non-polar solvent. Here I'm using a canola oil. You can use any vegetable oil, sunflower oil, vegetable oils, it doesn't matter. And then water as a polar solvent. So here we have water, and then this is the fine sand. Sand is optional, but usually we use in our laboratory. And then here is this paper boat. So paper boat, you can see I cut these small papers like this one, and then I will show you how to make these paper boards. So paper boards will behave like a test tube to collect the fractions from the column. So these are the two batches of, one is for non-polar compound, one is for polar compound. And we need trash container. So this bowl will be trash container, and we need some I have here some napkin or paper towel because I'm sure I'm going to spill some oil and water here, so I need to control to wipe it. And then very important thing, we need always safety goggles. So if you do not have safety goggles, no problem, you can use any your solar goggles. So these are the materials we need. So let's start our experiment to set up the column first. Okay, so before starting any organic chemistry experiments, so first we need to have a safety goggle. So wear the safety goggle first. And if you do not have safety goggles in home, so you can use any goggles, any glasses or sunglasses also. So I will use this one, sunglasses today. So let's use this one. And the first thing I want to show you how to use this paper. So what I did, I used this plain paper to make it one fold, then another second fold, and every time you have to cut them. Then one more fold. And one more. So probably from one page I can get 16, I think so, 16 paper. So once you get this kind of small rectangular paper, how you can make a paper boat? So fold like this. Then on the other side, then on the other side, from every side you have to fold it. Now you can open it. Once you will open, you will see like this one. So you can pinch from corner and fold it. Pinch from the corner, fold it. Pinch from the corner and then fold it. So now you can see my paper boat is ready. So this is the paper boat, and we will use the same paper to make a funnel. So what we will do, we'll make a cone like this one to add anything in the column. We'll use this paper funnel. Okay, so next is as I showed you, this is my empty pen. So we'll fill this
pen first with these cotton. And here I'm taking this a small straw to push the cotton inside. So let's take some cotton and make a small like this and push it inside. One round, this is the another second round. So here you can see I will add one more. So you need not too much cotton, just a small amount of cotton you need to fill it. I think this will be enough. So my column is ready. So this pen, empty pen, will behave like a column, and the cotton we added inside, this will behave like a silica gel, which is the stationary phase. And now how will it make it stand? So here we have this rubber band, two rubber bands, and this is my column. So one rubber band will go on the top of, oops, here like this one. Make it double so that it will stand nicely here. And we'll make one more rubber band to give more stability, like this one. We'll make one more chance to tight. I want to really make it tight so that it don't go away. So this is as same as we use a clamp holder. So now my column is ready. So we'll fill oil first to flush it, and then we'll start the adding compounds. So let's fill this one column. So now you can see my column is ready, and first step is to flush the column with oil, so or non-polar solvent. So here I'm using, as I showed you, that vegetable oil. So before adding anything, keep your trash bag here, trash container here, and use this paper as a paper towel. This is like a funnel. Put it here, make a cone, and make a paper paper funnel. So now my paper funnel is ready, and I'm going to use this dropper. So this dropper, take some oil and add it here. So now you can see oil is going inside. So we'll flush our column with oil first, and it will take some time, you know, so you have to be patient. If you have any air bubbler, we can use it. Otherwise we can blow our apply some air pressure also. So we'll wait till it will come down. I will show you after some time. Now you can see here, right now this oil is here, and if I will add a little bit more, you can use this straw to make it inside, so that it can go all the way inside. It will go slow. Now you can see the cotton is soaked in the oil up to this position. So cotton is soaked in oil up to here, and now I have to add another round of the, so that is why I have to make another funnel. This funnel is already gone, so you have to make many funnels from by adding anything. Now add more oil.
So you can see oil is going inside here. It will take some time, so now I can fill a little bit more oil. So here you can see this oil is coming. It's blurring. Now you can see my column is filled with the oil, and if I show you at this end, you can see the oil is dripping, and I can show you in my finger, you can see oil is dripped in my finger, and I can see also in the bottom. So my column is now ready to load the compound. So you can see right now the column is filled with the oil, and I blow the air here from this top, blow the air, because and it takes 5 to 7 minutes because oil flow was very slow. And now I'm going to add second step, which is adding compound. Now my column is ready here, oil is up to here completely, column is soaked with the oil. So next step is this sand. And I'm not going to add sand in this experiment. This will be optional for this experiment. So, no sand. Next is the second step is loading of compound. To load the compound, take this, make a funnel. And then I'm taking this vitamin E capsule. So here you can see this is coming. And next is once it is done, then add sugar. Little bit sugar. Probably it's not easy to add sugar directly. We need to add through so now you can see sugar is also inside here. And now we will start flushing, eluting this compound. Sugar and vitamin E. So now I will add some more oil to flush my compound. First oil, and then we'll wait till its droplet will come out. My column is running very nice, so we'll wait some time. Now you can see this after 5 minutes, and this oil level goes from here to here, and I can see one drop is coming, this oil drop is coming. So maybe we need to apply some pressure, you know. And here is this first drop is collected. So I will collect 5 drops here, 5 drops here, 5 drops here. So this will be my number 1, 2, 3, and then 4, 5, 6. So these will be my container. And then now since the oil level is goes down, so I have to fill some more oil. I'm using this probably it will not be a good idea. I should use a funnel. Now this is the, you can see here, this is the second drop is coming. So the column is running slow, but we will be eluted very easily. Maybe have to put the cotton rather than this much, half of this one. So here you can see this is the next drop came out. So same way we have to keep collecting 5 drop each in the my container. Now you can see the next drop is coming. This is the fourth drop, and here I put the funnel. So I'm going to add more oil through funnel. Now you can see this oil label is filled, and the only way to make it fast, either we have to reduce the cotton or we apply air pressure from the top. So because this gravity separation is very slow here, but it is working. Here you can see one drop is now, another drop is coming out. Now I have collected 5 drop in each one, and I label my each container paper boat 1, 2, 3, and you can see the oil label has dropped, so it's time to add another layer. Few more drops of oil, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So here now you can see this oil level is increasing. So basically it will take some time. One drop is still stuck here, so it will come soon. Now I'm going to label the other paper boards also. So now I am collecting in paper number board 4, 5. This is the last drop is coming. I added some more oil. We are almost done with this non-polar solvent eluent. After collecting 5 drops here also, we will switch to the water. So now you can see the oil has already came up to here, and brown sugar is still stuck here. It did not dissolve in the oil. And here I have collected 5 drops of each in the oil. So this experiment is done now. And next is we have to start with the water. So this is the another container. And we'll start to add water now. So another paper funnel. You have to make so many paper funnel every time because they got wet. So you have to make fresh paper funnel every time. So here I have added new paper funnel. And then I'm going to add this water. This time it is water only. So water will serve as a polar solvent. So let's add water here. So water flows very fast. Now it will dissolve the sugar and it will take it out. So we'll wait till water will start flowing down. Because first whatever the oil is here, it will come maybe 2 paper boat. First oil will come, then water will come, but water has more density, so it will flow very fast. Here you can see, it's coming down fast. Here I would like to give you more closer look. So you can see this brown sugar, it was here earlier in the oil. Now there is no brown sugar, it is all dissolving. So color is here, it's coming down. And in the first board, paper board, I collected, still oil is there. And here color has changed because the cotton is wet, so column got different color. And now I'm going to add some more water. Oh, look like it is so in the, maybe I can use this toothpick. So this is the reason I put a trash container here. You can see so many paper boards I have collected, and because every time they got wet. And here you need some paper towel if it is a spill. So one paper board is done. Now let's start collecting the fresh from the second one. And I can see the sugar is here right now. The color, brown color, is here. So it will come slowly, probably in the third container, in the third boat it will come. And now you can see water layer has goes down. And if you will see in this tip, it's all brown color. I will show you here, probably in this, no, I can see the brown color is at the tip. And also in the, here you can see this is brown color droplets. So now oil, sugar is coming out. So sugar is start coming out from number 2 and then 3. And now we have to switch to the other paper boat. And here we have to add some more water. It goes very fast. Maybe we have to make it a little bit, give some way to go inside. So you need a toothpick also to mix it. So now let's collect number 4. I am just moving this side. So you have to keep track your paper boat number as well. So these are the from oil and these are from the water. So now you can see water is flowing very fast. So level has goes very down very quickly. So I have to add more. My column is running very nice. So now my column is over, and so compound elution is over, and now we will do the analysis. So how we are going to do analysis from these paper boards, which we have collected oil here and water droplets are here. Since we use the vitamin E as a organic compound, so vitamin E have very kind of bad smell, or you can say like it smells like a fish. So I'm going to smell compound number 1, 2, 3, and this is like a 6, 5, and 4, and we'll make a graph where I can smell more fish like. Then in this container I eluted the brown sugar, so brown sugar will be analysis will be done by brown color. So here you can see some brown color droplets are here. Here I can see more, and it is fading here, and then in 5, 6 is nothing. So this was the example of how we can perform the column chromatography in the home atmosphere. And now we are going to make a graph of these analysis. So now after analysis all these paper boat for fish smell, for vitamins E, and brown color for brown sugar, I made this graph that vitamin E, fish smell, and relative amount on the y-axis. It could be like a none, some, and a small good smell. So 5 drop, 10 drop, 15 drop, 20 drop, 25 drop, 30 drop, because we collected 5 drop in each boat and 6 boats were there. And in case of brown sugar, this kind of graph we got it. None, some amount of the brown color, good amount, and the large amount. So this was the example of homemade column chromatography experiments, and you can try or try to make it better than this one and see, learn this technique.
So this was the simple experiment I tried at my home to demonstrate you the concept of column chromatography. And during this coronavirus pandemic period and through online teaching, we can try this experiment at home to learn this principle of the column chromatography, how it works, using this simple eluent which is available in our kitchen. And try your with your own and make your own observation and write a analysis graph and see how it will work. And if you have any comment or on this video, please write this one, and I hope this will be a good learning for you. Thank you.